Hallelujah. What a privilege it is to be in the house of God on this Easter Sunday. We want to lift up the wonderful name of Jesus, the King who died for us, rose again. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Lift your voice, lift your hands as we worship God together this morning and we sing that song, God of our salvation. Worship you, Lord. We lift up our voices. We glorify your wonderful name. Come and see his glory. Come just as you are. Come and hear the story of his heart. God so loved his children that he gave his only son, that we might be forgiven. Death has been overcome. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the God of our salvation. You are conquered. You are the God of our salvation. Oh, he gave his life for the weary. Now we worship you, we lift you up. Come, you tired and weary. Come just as you are. Come and let his mercy heal your heart. For God so loved his children, that he gave his only son, that we might be forgiven, death has been overcome. We sing, hallelujah, hallelujah, you are the God of our salvation. You have conquered, you have risen, you are the God of us. Hallelujah, yeah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the God of our salvation. You have conquered, you have risen, you are the God of our salvation. You have conquered, you have risen, you are the God of our salvation. Hallelujah, 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 you are the God of our salvation. You have conquered, you have risen, you are the God of our salvation. Hallelujah, we worship you, Jesus. We glorify you, God. We thank you, God, that you came down from heaven to save us, hallelujah, from ourselves. Lift your voice this morning as we continue to worship God. We sing that song together, Savior of the world. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God, we worship you, Jesus. We lift you up this morning, God, for who you are. Have you heard? Death has been conquered. Yeah. The that he's gone, the more he has come. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Every fear has been stripped of his power. Lord of life, you've already won. Oh, from a throne in heaven, from a throne in heaven to a sinner's cross, you bought our freedom with your outstretched arms. We praise the Savior of the world. Jesus is alive, Jesus is alive. The stone was rolled away. Our hope is built upon an empty grave. We praise the Savior of the world. Oh God, we worship you, Lord. Oh, come and see. There is hope. Thank you, Jesus. Come and see. There is hope from the ashes. The risen King will break every chain. Lift your voice and shout hallelujah. All the glory and honor forever to his name, to his name. From a throne in heaven to a sinner's cross, you bought our freedom with your outstretched arms. We praise the Savior of the world. Jesus is alive, the stone was rolled away. Our hope is built upon an empty grave. We praise the Savior of the world. From a throne. Holy name, hallelujah, because you came down to our world to save us, to redeem us. He's worthy of our worship and our praise. His name is to be lifted up this morning. There's no other God besides our God. Lift your voice, praise God. Señor, aquí estoy. Sé que
por tu sangre, Señor. Yo sé que mi Dios es tu gran amor, me diste tú por mí, regalo celestial. Majestad, tu gracia me encontró y me salvó. Destruido por mi muerto amor,
aquí estoy,
aquí estoy.
Sé que tu anhelo soy,
sé que tu anhelo soy. Perdonado para perdonar. Aquí estoy. Sé que tu anhelo soy. Santo por tu gloria y poder. Y hoy yo que Dios es tu amor, pediste tú por mí, regalo celestial.
By the stripes that he bore upon himself, we are healed. Hallelujah. By the nail pierced hand, we are free. We are delivered. Lift your voice as we continue to worship him this morning. He's worthy of our praise and our worship. This is the anthem of every sin, every believers. Hallelujah. That we can worship God this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. By his
stripes, we are healed. His nail pierced hands, we're free. By his blood, there was clean. Now we have the victory. The power of sin is broken. Jesus overcame it all. He has won our freedom.
Jesus, amen. The risen King this morning. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Jesus, you are worthy, God. Jesus, you are good, God. You are holy, God. Hallelujah, God, she called her own. See, hallelujah. Three.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Jesus,
you have won the
victory this morning. God, for you and me, God. God, you won, you won.
Hallelujah.
You won it all for me.
You have won it all for me.
Take hold you down, Lord. God, you're gonna hold me down, Lord. God, you're gonna raise us up, Lord.
You are the reason.
It's your risen.
Seated in majesty. You are the reason, King.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a clap offering this morning. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Jesus, you are holy, God. God, you are worthy, God. Praise God. Jesus Christ is alive. He's risen this morning. And that's a promise, listen, beloved, amen, for you and for me. Death could not hold him down. For the Christian this morning, death is temporal. But he will be risen from the grave, amen. Because he lives this morning, listen, we can live as well, amen, by the blood of Jesus. Let's praise God. Amen, God is good, amen. We want to welcome you this morning, especially if you're a visitor on this Resurrection Sunday, or if you're watching online. God bless you. Amen. We're believing God for you today, beloved. Amen. And so we have some prayer needs this morning. First of all, we simply want to pray and welcome again. If you are a visitor, maybe a first-time visitor here to the door, God bless you. Welcome to the door this morning. Amen.
Bienvenidos esta mañana a la puerta, aleluya. Si eres un visitante aquí, en este lugar, amén, aleluya. Bienvenidos esta mañana a la puerta, gloria a Dios.
And so thank God for you, beloved, amen. And so a couple of
needs we have. We've been praying for Johnny Ramirez, and Johnny's doing much better. He might be released today from the hospital in San Antonio. Our brother did suffer a heart attack, I think maybe two last week, and so they had to put a stent in him, and that's so he's been in the hospital in San Antonio. We believe in God, listen, just for a miracle healing, and so amen. Let's believe God for brother Johnny. We're praying also for salvation for Adam Hernandez this morning, beloved. We're praying for him today. We're praying, listen, also for all our domestic churches, and as they are having a resurrection Sunday this morning as well in Bryan College Station, the Bills there, Collin, Texas, the Parkers, Southeast Austin, La Puerta, the Reeses, Elgin, Texas, the Martinez's, Puna, Hawaii, the Palmas, Northeast Austin, the Hernandez's, our missionaries. Amen. We're praying for the Bernals in La Ceiba, Honduras, the Rashids in Roatan, Honduras, the Martinez's in Da Nang, Vietnam, and here very soon this month, amen, Jeremiah Geneva Wacker will be going to San Salvador, El Salvador. Amen. We're also praying, amen, for the Eugenios this morning. El Pastor Jorge Eugenio, su esposa Lucy, as you're here this morning. Amen. From Madrid, Spain. We're praying for them, their daughter, and their congregation back in Spain. We're praying also, beloved, for our fellowship leaders, Pastor Greg Mitchell, Pastor Warner, Pastor Stevens, Pastor Ruby, and as always, our Austin, Texas church staff. Believing God, we've covered your prayers this morning. We pray, as always, for our military as well, beloved. Let's pray for the leaders in our nation, and we're praying for you, especially, again, if you're a visitor today. Thank God for you. Maybe this morning here on this Resurrection Sunday, you've got a need today. Maybe it's a family member. Maybe somebody needs healing. Maybe you're watching online. You're like, you know, we just kind of tapped into this. Like, I don't know what's going on here. But listen, we're praying for you this morning, believing God to help you. Amen. And so as we do that this morning, we're getting a hold of Jesus this morning. Amen. I'm going to ask, Pastor Manuel Macias to come to the front. Amen. And bring us to the throne of mercy and grace. Let's believe God this day. Amen. Father, we thank you, God, this morning, God, for all that you're doing, God.
Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, en este día por el privilegio, Señor, de estar en tu casa una vez más. Te damos gracias, Señor, por ese precioso sacrificio que hiciste en esa cruz. Señor, tú estás vivo, tú resucitaste, Señor, en este día, y clamamos, Señor, que tu sangre preciosa con poder, Señor, toque en este día, Señor, a través de tu siervo. Unge tu mensaje, Señor, sana aquel que está enfermo en cuerpo, porque todavía hay poder en esa sangre preciosa que derramaste en esa cruz. Celebramos en este día, Señor, que tú vives y tú reinas por siempre. Gracias, te damos, Señor, en el nombre poderoso de Cristo Jesús. Amén, amén.
Praise God. Why don't you welcome each other to church this morning? Turn to your left, to your right, please. Welcome, especially visitors, beloved. Amen.
Aleluya. Jesus is alive. Death has lost its victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He's alive. He's alive.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is alive. Death has lost its victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He's alive. He's alive. He's the Alpha and Omega, the first and last we see. The curse of sin is broken, and we have perfect liberty. The Lamb of God is risen. He's alive. He's alive. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive. Death has lost its victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He's alive. He's alive.
He's the Alpha and Omega.
He's the Alpha and Omega, the first and last we see. The curse of sin is broken, and we have perfect liberty. For the Lamb of God has risen, He's alive, He's alive.
Praise God. Jesus Christ is alive. Happy Resurrection Day. How many, listen, are happy this morning? And thank God. This is a great, great day. And so thank God for you. First of all, foremost, if you are a visitor here this morning, we want to welcome you to the Door Christian Fellowship Church, where Jesus Christ is changing lives. How many appreciate visitors this morning? Come on, somebody. Si eres visitante aquí esta mañana, aquí a la puerta, gloria a Dios, amén. Bienvenidos aquí, están en su casa. Y gracias que están aquí, amén. And so praise God for you. And thank God, amén. A couple of things I have, beloved, in the way of announcements. We have a special treat for us this morning and tonight. Preaching the word of God all the way from Madrid, Spain, is Pastor Jorge Eugenio. And we're just coming off of an El Paso conference, and so we got an opportunity to get him. I thought it'd be a great opportunity, and so they got a great church there in Madrid. I was able to preach there in August, and so I tell you what, God is doing a great thing. And so you're going to be in for a treat this morning. He's going to preach in Spanish. We're going to have an interpreter in English, okay, with slides in English. So the Word of God is going to be preached in two languages this morning. And so thank God for that. So we have him this morning and this evening, and you're going to be blessed, I guarantee you. A couple of things we have, beloved. Don't forget tonight, so we have prayer at 6 o'clock, and let's believe all that God's going to do. Also, just as a note, immediately following the altar call, we are going to do the Lord's Supper, okay? And I'll explain all the details on that later, but all the ushers will be ready and everything else, and I'll explain the procedures, etc. And so just don't be in a, too much of a rush to take your brisket or something off your grill, okay? Your smoker. So let's gonna believe all that God's gonna do. Can you say amen? It shouldn't take that long, but it's gonna be a great time in that. Let's see here. For our local church also, and certainly want to encourage people, we do have for the men this coming Monday, we have a men's discipleship at 7:30 p.m. in San Antonio with Pastor Greg Mitchell. You don't want to miss that. And then throughout the week, we have prayer, daily prayer in the morning, as early as 6:30 in the morning through 8 o'clock right here. And let's see here. Also, we have a midweek service, prayer at 6:30, 7:30 in the evening. We have a Spanish service on Thursday night, servicio en español, cada jueves a las 7:30 de la noche. Aquí estamos con el Pastor Manuel Macias. And so we want to invite people for that. That Spanish ministry has been growing, and praise God for that. Can you say amen? And I believe this Friday is Bible study fellowship night, and believing God for that. And also, just very, very quick, this coming Saturday, we do have a major invasion team right here as we're going to get ready to have our annual miracle healing crusade with Pastor Mark Olson. Amen. Right around the corner, we might have the flyers for that. The slides for that. And so that's going to be the healing crusade with Pastor Olson is right around the corner. So just getting ready for that. Let's believe all that God's going to do, beloved. Amen. We did have a very quick invasion team report. Jeremiah Wacker, where you're at. And so he's going to come up very quickly. You got 2 minutes. Tell folks what happened yesterday, Northeast Austin. Amen.
All right. So yesterday we went with Pastor Mayo. About 30 of us went to Northeast Austin. We hit the streets. In about an hour, we got rid of 2,000 flyers. With all the baby churches and us included, there was over 60 people at his church. We did a outdoor concert. The Word of God was preached. Pastor Mayo is having revival over there. They have a lot of new people that I've never seen that are out there just passing out flyers, witnessing, looking like veterans. So God is doing a quick work over there. So thank you to everyone who made it out. We really appreciate you guys.
Amen, God, it's good. Amen. We're going to receive an offering this morning for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'll make the El Paso conference announcements tonight. Amen. A lot of churches got sent out. In fact, there was a church from Spain, from Pastor Eugenio's church. It got launched out as well. So God really did move, and God helped us in El Paso. We'll have some testimonies as the week progresses. Amen. We're going to receive an offering this morning for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, beloved. Hallelujah. How many are ready to give this morning on this Easter? Story goes of a lady named Margaret Sangster Phippen. She wrote that back in 1950, her father, British minister W.E. Sangster, began to notice some kind of uneasiness in his throat. He began to drag his leg. He went to a doctor. They found he had an incurable disease, it said, a sort of progressive muscular atrophy. His muscles would gradually waste away. His voice would fail. His throat would soon become unable to swallow. Sangster threw himself into his work. He had missionaries, and he got involved with them, British missionaries, figuring he could still write and even have more time for prayer. He said this, "Let me stay in the struggle, and I don't mind if I can no longer be a general, but give me just a regiment to lead." He's still willing to lead after all that. He wrote articles, books, he did all these things, but I was impressed with what he said towards the end when his voice was almost completely gone. It said this, he could still hold a pen shakily, and on Resurrection Sunday morning, just a few weeks before he had passed, he wrote a letter to his daughter, and in it he said, It is terrible to wake up on Easter morning and have no voice to shout, "He is risen." But it would be still more terrible to have a voice and not want to shout, "He is risen." How many know? And although we're not told of this voice coming from this disciple after the resurrection, we do have speculation that this indeed happened to a man named Joseph of Arimathea. Question this morning, beloved, have you ever been asked to give something of value not knowing its outcome? How many can say yes, amen? This happened to Joseph of Arimathea. Listen to this morning. In Mark 15, 42, the ushers can hold up just a little bit. "Now when evening had come, because it was the preparation day, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a prominent council member, who was himself waiting for the kingdom of God, coming and taking courage, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate marveled that he was already dead. And summoning the centurion, he asked him if he had been dead for some time. Verse 45, "So when he found out from the centurion, he granted the body to Joseph. Then he bought fine linen, took him down, wrapped him in the linen. He laid him in a tomb which had been hewn out of the rock, and rolled a stone against the door of the tomb." Here's a man named Joseph of Arimathea. He's a biblical figure, and he played an important role, in the burial of Christ. He's a disciple. You don't hear much about him. Him along with Nicodemus. You remember John chapter 3? When Nicodemus comes by night, and basically I believe he's going to warn Jesus, "Listen, those guys over there, sir, they want to kill you." But Jesus knew that already. And he point blank said, "Unless you're born again, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God." So here are these two men, Joseph of Arimathea, Nicodemus, prominent men, men that had position in the Jewish council, one certainly in the Sanhedrin. And the Bible says that here's this man, he's prominent. He was actually part of the Sanhedrin, but here we understand that he was opposed to the crucifixion of Christ because, in fact, Joseph of Arimathea was a follower of Jesus. We understand Joseph was a wealthy man. In Matthew 27:57, it says that he came there a rich man. So we don't know where his wealth came from necessarily, but no doubt he's a wealthy man, maybe a business, I'm not sure. And the Bible also refers to Joseph of Arimathea as a good and upright man in Luke 23:50. And so here are these men, Joseph and Nicodemus, boldly, with great risk, request the body of Jesus from Pontius Pilate. I can imagine, first of all, that took lots of boldness. They're like, all right, fine, take the body. I want to plead and say that Joseph was a man of faith. Here's Joseph of Arimathea, having no doubt a place, a hewn rock, for one day it would have been his burial ground. And here is this brand new place, a plot of property, if you will, no doubt costly for a wealthy man in that place. And he's simply saying, this is going to be going to Jesus. Here you could say he gave without any sure returns. He's a follower. He's simply being obedient. But unbeknownst to Joseph and Nicodemus, their choice to put Jesus in Joseph's tomb fulfilled Isaiah's prophecy, spoken hundreds of years before. Listen to Isaiah 53:9. He was assigned a grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. This is one of the many prophecies, beloved, that confirmed Jesus, listen, indeed, is the Messiah. He's the Son of God. And the day after Jesus' burial, the chief priests and the Pharisees went to Pilate to request that the stone that Joseph had placed there be sealed. They put a guard out there, many soldiers out there for 3 days. As they were told, listen, you never know, these disciples might come back and try to steal the body. I would say with that fat chance, not with all the soldiers there and the seal itself there, that if you broke the seal, that's automatic death. Yet, that was not enough, and that certainly didn't keep Jesus in. Because the Bible says in Mark 16:1, are you with me, church? Now when the Sabbath, that's just going to come forward, passed, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices that they might come and anoint him. Very early in the morning on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen. And they said amongst themselves, who will roll away the stone from the door of the tomb for us? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away, for it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in a long white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified? He is risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. It's empty. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him as he said to you. I said all that, beloved, to say this morning, listen to me. Here, no doubt, we don't have the scripture, but here's Joseph Arimathea. I would say at some point he heard that news. Followers heard that news that Jesus is risen. The Bible says he appeared to 500 followers. Many people saw him alive. Very quickly, if somebody told you they saw a dead man walking, you would go like, are you okay? If 3 people said they saw a dead man walking, you would probably say, is this a conspiracy? But if 500 people tell you they saw a dead man walking, we would be fools to not go look ourselves. Can you say amen? And so now here, no doubt, listen, here's the disciple. This man and others, no doubt, beloved, heard that good news. And thank God for that. I'm saying that to simply say, here's Joseph. Listen, he just was obedient, gave to the Lord, had faith, no doubt, as to what he was going to do. But here it is, right there. Not until the third day was that proof made known. Are you with me this morning? Last story we're going to give this morning, beloved. And I want you to give this Easter like you've never given before. This is a story. I heard this from Pastor Roman Gutierrez at the El Paso Conference. He told the story of Brother Richard Barrera. He, back in 2012, I was the pastor there, the second pastor into San Marcos, Texas. Roman was like number four, I think, or three. And so the San Marcos church at that time that Pastor Gutierrez was there, I believe it's 2012, were having their harvesters, and Roman's looking, and they're like, we're going to be short. Richard went to his 401k, and he helped pay for the majority of their harvesters. He still got the savings. Like, man, I'm not doing anything good. Just I'm going to give it to the Lord. Fast forward it, I believe it's 2022. Richard Barrera, the doctor said, was dying of COVID. And there he is. And so many pastors got that word, you know, to pray for Richard. Pastor Gutierrez actually went there and began to pray for him. And listen, right there, Pastor Roman took a picture with Richard. He's right there on the bed. Didn't look good. But he's like, you know what? God's going to help you, Richard. The very next day, Roman Gutierrez, his wife takes a video, and here's Richard Barrera. Roman Gutierrez said that there's Richard walking with a walker. The very next day, at this last, I think 25th, I was able to go there, and here's Richard and Mary Jane next to me, and he's there, he's doing great today. I mean, he's alive and well. Thank God for that. I'm saying all that to say this. Way back in 2012, when he gave like that, unbeknownst to him, as time went on, I believe the Lord remembered that offering. So you know what? You gave considerably. Listen, it's not always going to come back necessarily in a monetary value. But I believe, listen, the Lord remembered our brother and said, you know what? Hey, man, I'm gonna help you today. I'm going to help you today. And this man lived. Can I ask you a question this morning? What miracle are you looking for on this resurrection day? And if indeed you're looking for something that God to do, can you say, Lord, I'm going to be like Joseph of Arimathea. I'm going to give my best. Because one day the king is going to rise. By the way, Joseph of Arimathea, legend says, he became a missionary in Britain. Let's bow our hearts this morning. Here's this Easter Sunday morning, or you're online this morning. I want you to give like you've never given before. Not a token offering. An offering that's worthy. An offering that you're going to say, God, I'm giving this morning. We're going to believe all that God's going to do, beloved, today. Amen. And as we do that today, I'm going to ask my brother, amen, Isaac, to pray for this offering.
For the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. For great is he who is King of kings and Lord of lords, he is wonderful. For great is he who is King of kings.
God the Almighty.
Sing hallelujah now.
Hallelujah for the Lord our God the Almighty.
Sing hallelujah, church.
Hallelujah for the Lord our God the Almighty.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah for the Lord our God the Almighty.
Praise God. We have special music this morning. Hallelujah. Azalea, Lisa, Eliza, the girls are here coming up. Are they ready to go? All right. God's good.
Hello. My name is Lisa. For those of you that don't know me, just share a quick testimony of what Jesus has done in my life. 24 years ago, I was only 17. I was just battling heavily with suicide. I had just tried to end my life. And maybe about a few days to a week later, someone came to my door and told me about Jesus. And that night, I surrendered my life to him. He's delivered me from suicide, just anger, hatred, bitterness. And I'm here standing today, a miracle because of him. And this song is about the commission, you know, just to go out and tell the world about Jesus. And that's what they did. And if it wasn't for them sharing his truth with me, I would not be standing here today.
Praise God. Amen. Lisa and her daughters, how many appreciated that this morning? I tell you what a blessing that was. Amen. Thank God for that. Amen. Hallelujah. You can clap. You can clap. Amen. Listen, as you're getting ready with the pulpit here, I got the privilege to meet Pastor Jorge, Eugenio, and Lucy, and their daughter Sophia, was able to go to Spain, Madrid, and preach there. And so went there, got a tremendous church there in Madrid, beloved. And so he was telling me 18 years ago, they got saved because El Paso, launched a pioneer work there, a couple there to that place. And so they got saved. They're the result of, listen, missionaries going to another country. And so, unbeknownst to them, a little bit of time went on. I believe after 5 years, they took over the work. So they've been there leading that church for the last 13 years in Madrid, Spain. And they've got three churches out now. They just launched another church this past conference in El Paso. And God's doing a tremendous thing. And there certainly are, several churches in Madrid, but certainly this is a leadership church there, no doubt. And listen, we are just privileged to have all the way from Madrid, Spain, Pastor Jorge Eugenio. Okay.
Hola, sí.
Okay. ¿Listo? Check.
Okay. Amén. Le damos las gracias por la invitación al pastor Rola Pérez y su esposa y a toda la congregación de aquí de Austin.
We give thanks to Pastor Perez and Liz and the Austin congregation to be here.
Amen. Veo una tremenda iglesia.
I see a tremendous church.
El pastor Roland Perez estuvo con nosotros el año pasado por el mes de agosto.
Pastor Perez was out there last year in August.
Hizo un buen trabajo allí en Madrid.
He did a tremendous job in Madrid.
Nos trajo palabra de Dios.
He brought the word of God.
Tiene un buen pastor.
You guys have a great pastor.
Amen. Amen. Reciba un saludo de la iglesia de Madrid.
You receive a hi from the Church of Madrid.
Amen. Estamos muy contentos, amen, de estar aquí en Austin.
We are so happy to be here in Austin.
Una ciudad moderna.
It's a modern church, city.
Amen. Vamos a gozar en esta mañana.
We're going to be here in the Word of God.
Estamos aquí con mi esposa y mi hija.
We are here with my wife and my daughter.
Y con la expectativa de lo que Dios va a hacer en este lugar, en este día.
And with the expectation of God what's going to do.
¿Cuántos saben que Jesucristo resucitó de la muerte?
How many know that Jesus has risen from the dead?
Amen.
Amen.
Jesucristo está vivo.
Jesus is alive.
Y Él está aquí en esta mañana.
And He's here this morning.
Para ayudarte.
To help you guys.
Para resucitar.
To resurrect.
¿Tú crees que estás aquí en esta mañana y crees que lo que estás pasando ya está todo muerto? No hay solución, no hay salida.
Do you think you're here this morning, you think everything's dead, there's no hope, there's no exit?
Pero Jesucristo dice, yo puedo resucitar para lo que tú piensas que está muerto.
And Jesus says, I can resurrect what you think it's dead.
No es casualidad que estés en esta mañana.
There's not a coincidence you're here this morning.
Hermano que estás allí de gorra, que tienes la polera blanca.
Brother there over there with that cap, with that white t-shirt.
No es casualidad, sí, tu hermano. Cuando te saludé, Sentí que Dios quiere ayudarte. No es casualidad que hayas venido. Tú has venido para ver qué Dios hace en tu vida.
It's not a coincidence when I say hi to you that God has brought you here because He has a purpose for you.
No importa lo que hayas hecho.
It doesn't matter what you have done.
Dice Dios, yo te quiero ayudar.
Jesus says, I want to help you.
No es casualidad.
It's not a coincidence.
Quiero usar tu vida.
He wants to use your life.
Quiero darte un destino.
I want to give you a destiny.
Quiero resucitar lo que hay muerto en ti.
I want to resurrect what is dead inside.
Quiero darte vida.
I want to give you life.
Y en abundancia.
In abundance.
Porque Él quiere usar tu vida.
Because He wants to use your life.
Y no es casualidad.
It's not a coincidence.
Él quiere ayudarte.
He wants to help you.
Y tú has venido por una palabra.
And you have come for a word.
Y Dios te la va a dar.
And God is going to give it to you.
Y Dios te está hablando ahora mismo.
And God is speaking to you right now.
Te está diciendo, yo quiero usarte.
He's telling you, I want to use you.
Quiero ayudarte.
I want to help you.
¿Crees que es Dios?
Do you think it's God?
Dios te va a ayudar esta mañana.
God is going to help you this morning.
Vamos a pasar la palabra de Dios.
Let's go to the word of God.
Libro de Juan, capítulo 11.
Let's go to John, chapter 11.
Mientras vas allí,
while you go there,
un artículo que leí tiempo atrás,
an article that I read
que salió hace cuatro años,
que it came out 4 years ago,
decía, lo dieron por muerto.
It said they left him for dead.
Lo enterraron, pero cuatro meses después apareció vivo en el cementerio.
They buried him, but 4 months later he appeared alive in the cemetery.
Esta familia quedó en shock.
This family was in shock.
Y sin entender lo que estaba pasando cuando las autoridades notificaron la reaparición de uno de sus miembros.
And they didn't, and they were shocked, and they didn't know what had happened to see one of the members who had died months ago.
Que había fallecido meses atrás.
He has passed 4 months ago.
La familia catalogó la reaparición de Mohamed Jamal como
the family cataloged the reappearance of Mohamed Halad Ganal.
Volvió de entre los muertos.
He had returned from the dead.
El cual habían llorado y sepultado exactamente 4 meses atrás.
Who had mourned and buried exactly 4 months ago.
La familia manifestó sin entender lo que estaba pasando.
The family expressed without understanding what had happened.
Lo enterramos hace 4 meses.
We buried him 4 months ago.
Pero Mohamed fue reportado como fallecido a inicio de 2020.
Mohamed was reported deceased at the beginning of 2020.
Y enterrado ante la tristeza de sus hijos, sus hermanos y amigos.
And buried to the sadness of his children, brothers and friends.
Al llegar a la central de la policía,
when they arrived at the police headquarters,
no había duda de quién encontraron vivo y caminando.
There was no doubt who they found alive and walking them.
Fue el mismo Mohamed.
They went to the same person, Mohamed.
Según lo sucedido,
according to what happened,
es que todos confundieron el cuerpo de un fallecido con el de Mohamed.
Everyone mistook the body of a deceased person for that of Mohamed,
que en ese momento estaba desaparecido.
Who was missing at that time.
Además, la clínica nunca le brindó a la familia los resultados de las pruebas del ADN.
And furthermore, the clinic never provided the family the results of the DNA test performed.
Los familiares ahora lloraban de la emoción de saber que estaba muerto, de saber el que estaba muerto.
The relative was now crying with the emotion of knowing that the one who was dead had risen from the dead.
Piensa, el que estaba muerto,
think, who was dead,
había resucitado,
has risen.
Ellos decían, ha resucitado de la muerte.
They said, he has risen from the dead.
Eso es increíble.
That is incredible.
Ellos no lo podían creer.
They couldn't understand it.
De que su familiar,
that their families,
al que habían enterrado hace 4 meses,
who had buried 4 months ago,
ahora estaba entre ellos vivo.
Now he was among them.
Sabes, esto fue una confusión.
You know, this was a confusion.
Él estaba vivo, el familiar Mohamed.
The family Mohamed, he was alive.
Habían enterrado a otro.
They had buried somebody else.
Que no era Mohamed.
There was not Mohamed.
Entonces fue una confusión.
There was a confusion.
Pero en el texto que vamos a leer,
but the text we're going to read, amen,
nos habla de que Jesucristo,
they speak, amen, about Jesus.
Él tiene el poder, la vida y la muerte.
He has the power of death and life.
La historia nos habla de Lázaro.
The story speaks about Lazarus.
Lázaro había muerto.
Lazarus had died.
Ya 4 días.
4 days has passed.
Ya olía.
He smells.
Estaba en un estado de descomposición.
He was on a state of decomposition.
Y aquí está el Señor Jesús en esta escena.
And Jesus is right there on that scene.
Y Marta le dice, no hay solución.
And Martha says, there's no solution.
Ya no hay salida.
There's no exit.
No hay esperanza.
There's no hope.
Lázaro está muerto.
Lazarus, it is dead.
Gusanos están saliendo por su cuerpo ya.
Worms are coming out of his body.
Apestaba.
It smells.
No hay solución, Señor.
There's no solution.
Y el Señor le dice,
and God says,
en el versículo 25,
verses 25,
dice, yo soy la resurrección y la vida.
I'm the resurrection and the life.
El que cree en mí,
he who believes in
aunque
me,
esté muerto,
through he may die,
vivirá.
He shall
¿tú puedes
live.
Creer eso?
Do you believe that?
¿Crees eso?
You believe that?
Para ti en esta mañana,
for you this morning,
hay cosas que están muertas para ti.
There's things inside of you that are dead.
Que no hay solución, no hay salida.
There's no solution, there's no exit.
Que no hay esperanza.
There's no hope.
Pero Jesucristo dice,
but Jesus says,
yo puedo resucitar.
I can resurrect
lo que está muerto para
what
ti.
What is dead inside.
¿Lo puedes creer?
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Amen.
Quizás en esta mañana,
maybe this morning,
tú necesitas tener una resurrección espiritual también.
You might have a spiritual resurrection.
Necesitas tener un encuentro personal con Cristo.
You need to have an encounter with God personally.
Y él va a ayudarte en esta mañana.
And he's going to help you this morning.
Quizá tú no eres salvo.
Maybe you're going through some.
No eres salva.
Maybe you're not saved, or you're not saved.
Hoy Dios va a ayudarte.
God is going to help you this morning.
Hoy Dios va a resucitarte.
God is going to resurrect you.
Va a darte vida.
He's going to give you life.
¿Lo crees?
Do you believe?
Quiero predicarte sobre el poder de su resurrección.
I want to preach the power of resurrection.
Vamos a ver primeramente la vida de Cristo.
We're going to see the life of Christ.
¿Sabes? La vida de Cristo,
you know, the life of Christ,
en su cuerpo fue una vida limitada.
In his body there was a limit.
Él fue un hombre de carne y hueso, así como tú y yo.
He was just like us, you know, flesh and bones.
Estaba muy limitado a hacer ciertas cosas.
He was limited to do certain things.
No podía hacer todo lo que quería hacer él.
He couldn't do everything that he wanted to do.
Así como usted y como yo.
Just like you and me.
Muy limitados estamos.
There's limited things
porque
in us.
Porque somos seres carnales.
Because we are human and carnal.
Su cuerpo,
his body,
no su cuerpo lo limitaba.
His body was limited.
Si usted ve los evangelios,
if you see the word of God,
el Señor estaba limitado a ciertas cosas.
God is limited to do certain things.
En un lugar no pudo sanar a muchos.
And there was a place where he couldn't heal everyone.
Él oraba por enfermos y enfermos eran sanados.
He would pray with sick people and they were healed.
Pero en otros lugares no había los mismos resultados.
But other places there was not the same results.
Porque estaba en su cuerpo estaba limitado.
Because his body was limited.
El Señor Jesús se cansaba.
He was tired.
Así como usted y yo nos cansamos.
Just like you and I get tired.
Él necesitaba descansar.
He needed to rest.
Amén. Él necesitaba comer. Tenía
hambre. He needed to eat. He was hungry.
Amén. Él necesitaba dormir.
He needed to sleep.
En Mateo 8 vemos que está en la barca durmiendo.
We know that he was asleep on the boat.
Él está cansado. Necesita descansar.
He's tired. He needs to rest.
Él estaba en un cuerpo humano.
He's in a human body.
Quiero que entienda.
I want you to understand.
Él está limitado.
He is limited.
Era Dios en la carne.
He was God in flesh.
Amén. Era susceptible a pecar, aunque nunca lo hizo.
He was susceptible to sin, although he never did.
Por eso vemos en Mateo 4.
That's why we see in Matthew 4.
En la tentación del desierto.
The temptation in the desert.
El diablo está allí.
Satan is there.
El Señor Jesús venía de un ayuno de 40 días.
Jesus was coming from a fast of 40 days.
Dice la Biblia que él sintió hambre.
The Bible says that he felt hungry.
Él tenía hambre.
He was hungry.
Y el diablo sabe.
And the devil knows.
Y por eso le dice.
And that's what he says.
A que estas piedras se conviertan en pan.
Make these rocks bread.
Porque el diablo vio.
The devil amen. Saw, amen.
Sintió vio que tenía cierta hambre.
He saw that God
entonces
was
fue tentado
hungry, and he went tempted.
El Señor podía haber convertido esas piedras en pan.
Jesus could have
those
rocks to bread.
Pero no lo hizo.
But he didn't do it.
Amen. Quiero que entienda
amen.
Eso. Entonces vemos que él tenía ciertas debilidades, hambres,
that.
Apetitos, se cansaba igual como nosotros, pero era el Dios en la carne.
We saw that he was limited, he was hungry, he was sleepy, he was in the flesh.
Él podía de un momento a otro, o sea, caer en pecado.
In every in given day he could have fell into temptation.
Quiero que entienda, él estaba limitado.
I want you to understand he was limited.
Tenía las mismas pasiones.
He had the same passions.
Porque estaba en un cuerpo de carne y hueso.
Because he was in a body like yours, flesh and bones.
Hebreos capítulo 4.
Hebrews 4.
Versículo 15.
15.
Dice, no tenemos un sumo sacerdote que no pueda compadecerse de nuestras debilidades, sino uno que fue tentado en todo según nuestra semejanza, pero sin pecado.
We do not have a high priest who cannot emphasize what our weaknesses, but one who was tempted in every way as we are, yet without sin.
Si te das cuenta, Cristo tenía la capacidad completamente de destruir su destino.
If you realize, he had the capacity to destroy his destiny.
De pecar.
To sin.
Pero sin embargo no lo hizo.
But he never did.
Él no destruyó su destino.
He never destroyed his destiny.
Él podía haber dicho no a la voluntad del Padre.
He could have said no to the will of God.
Pero no lo hizo.
But he didn't do it.
O sea, si usted se da cuenta,
so if you realize,
al punto donde te quiero llevar,
the point that I want to take you,
es que Cristo tenía las mismas debilidades que usted y yo teníamos.
Christ has the same weaknesses that you and I have.
Nuestra vida antes de Cristo no era vida.
Our life before God was not life.
Éramos muertos andantes, caminantes.
We were dead walking people.
¿Cuánto han visto a aquellas personas ahí en Filadelfia, en Kensington, que se drogan?
Well, how many have seen those people in Philadelphia, in Lexington, who are drug addicts?
Aquellos drogadictos le llaman los zombies.
Those people, they call them zombies.
Parece que estuvieran muertos.
They look like they're dead.
¿Ha visto esos reportajes?
Have you seen that program?
No tienen voluntad propia.
They don't have the will.
La droga los tiene, la droga domina su voluntad.
The drugs take dominion of their lives.
Así era antes nuestra vida.
That was our life before Christ.
El pecado dominaba nuestra voluntad.
The sin had us tied.
Amen.
Amen.
El pecado tenía el dominio, éramos esclavos del pecado.
We were slaves to sin.
Efesios 2:1.
Ephesians 2:1.
Estabais muertos en vuestros delitos y pecados, dice.
You were dead in your trespasses and sins.
No teníamos la vida de Cristo.
We didn't have Christ, the love of Christ.
Estábamos separados del amor de Dios.
We were separated from the love of God.
Estábamos muertos espiritualmente.
We were dead spiritually.
Por nuestros pecados.
For our sins.
No teníamos vida verdadera.
We didn't have no real life.
Era una fachada de vivir.
It was a facade of living.
Una apariencia.
It was just a facade.
No vivíamos.
We were not living.
Parecíamos esos zombies.
We looked at those zombies.
No teníamos la vida de Cristo.
We didn't have the life of Christ.
¿Cuánto me están entendiendo?
How many understand that?
Y por esa vida,
and for that life,
por eso muchos pensaban,
that's what a lot of us think,
en el suicidio, en quitarse la vida,
on suicide or taking our lives,
porque por dentro de ellos no había vida,
because inside of them there was no life,
no estaba la vida de Dios,
there was not life of Christ inside,
estábamos muertos espiritualmente,
we were dead spiritually,
por eso pensábamos como pensábamos,
that's why we thought like the way we thought.
Hacíamos lo que hacíamos.
We did what we did.
Por eso nos emborrachábamos.
That's why we got drunk.
Nos drogábamos.
We were getting drug addict.
Hacíamos cosas locas.
We did a lot of crazy stuff.
Estábamos limitados de poder de hacer lo bueno.
We were limited to do the right thing.
Porque éramos esclavos del pecado.
Because we were slaves to sin.
No podíamos hacer cosas buenas.
We couldn't do right things, good things.
No teníamos dominio sobre nuestras vidas.
We didn't have dominion over life.
No teníamos dominio de decir no a ciertas cosas.
We couldn't have dominion to say no to certain things.
Porque el pecado había tomado dominio de nuestra voluntad.
Because sin has taken dominion over our
lives. Éramos esclavos.
We were slaves.
Por eso intentábamos cambiar.
That's why we were trying to change.
Y no podíamos porque no podíamos parar de pecar.
And we couldn't stop sinning.
Yo me acuerdo.
I remember.
A antes de ser salvo,
before I got saved,
yo intentaba cambiar.
I was trying to change.
Dos o tres meses,
two or three months,
y volví a lo mismo.
And I went back to the same thing.
Yo decía, ya no voy a volver a tomar.
I used to say, I'm not going to drink again.
Ya no voy a drogarme.
I'm not going to take drugs.
Ya no voy a hacer cosas malas.
I'm not going to do bad things.
Oh, un mes todo bien.
Oh, 1 month it was all fine.
Dos meses todo bien.
Two months it was okay.
El tercer mes,
but on the third month,
peor que el diablo.
I was worse than the devil.
No podía cambiar por mi propia cuenta.
I couldn't change on my own will.
Porque no tenía voluntad propia.
Because I didn't have my own will.
Estaba dominado por el pecado.
I was bound on.
No podíamos parar de pecar.
We couldn't stop sinning.
Juan 8:34.
John
8:34. Dice, de cierto os digo que todo aquel que practica el pecado, esclavo es del pecado.
Surely, surely, truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who practices sin is slave to sin.
Amen. Éramos esclavos.
We were slaves.
Una vida sin Cristo.
One life with Christ.
Es una vida que no tiene esperanza.
It's a life that has no hope.
Es una vida que no tiene solución.
It's a life that has no hope.
Es una vida que está atrapada en el pecado.
It's a life that it's bound in sin.
Es esclavo.
It's slaves.
El pecado ha esclavizado tu voluntad.
The sin has
el pecado
made you slave.
El pecado te tiene separado de la gracia de Dios.
The sin has separated you from the love of Christ.
Del amor de Dios.
The love of God.
Pero por eso Cristo murió.
But that's why Christ died.
Para ayudarnos.
To help you.
De eso te quiero hablar segundamente. De la muerte de Cristo.
For the love of, for the death of Christ.
Sabes, era necesario que Cristo muriera.
You know what? It was necessary for Christ to die.
Esto no era casualidad.
It was not something
no
that
era
just
un plan. No era un plan B. Cristo tenía.
It was not a plan that Christ had to die.
Para ayudarnos.
To help us.
Mateo 16:21.
Matthew 16:21.
Desde entonces comenzó Jesús a declarar a sus discípulos que era necesario ir a Jerusalén y padecer mucho a manos de los ancianos, de los principales sacerdotes y de los escribas, y ser muerto y resucitar al tercer día.
From then on, Jesus began to declare to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders and chief priests and the scribes, and be killed and resurrected on the third day.
O sea, que Cristo muriera por la humanidad, que muriera por nosotros, por usted y por mí, hermano, no era casualidad.
The Christ that died for our humanity was not God's plan for us.
No era un nuevo plan.
It was not a new plan.
No era un plan B de Dios.
It was not plan B for God.
Esto era necesario.
This was necessary.
Que Cristo muriera.
The Christ for Christ to die.
Para salvar a la humanidad.
To save humanity.
Una humanidad que había pecado.
A humanity that had sinned.
Que estaba atrapada en el pecado.
It was trapped in sin.
1 Pedro 1:18-21.
1 Peter 1:18-21.
Pues ya sabéis que fuisteis rescatados de vuestra vana manera de vivir, la cual recibiste vuestros padres, no con cosas corruptibles como oro o plata, sino con la sangre preciosa de Cristo, como de un cordero sin mancha y sin contaminación. Él estaba destinado desde antes de la fundación del mundo, pero ha sido manifestado en los últimos tiempos por amor de vosotros, por medio de que de él creéis en Dios, quien lo resucitó de los muertos y le ha dado gloria, para que vuestra fe y esperanza sean en Dios.
For you know that you have resurrected from your vain ways of life, which you received from your fathers, not with corruptible things such as gold or silver, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of lamb without spot and without defilement. He was destined before the foundation of the world, but it was being manifested in recent times for love of you. Through him you believe in God, who raised him from the dead and has given him glory, so that your faith and hope may be in God.
El que Cristo fuera a la cruz,
for Jesus to go to the cross,
muriera en esa cruz,
and died on that cross,
era su plan desde la fundación del mundo.
That was the plan from the foundation of the world.
No era un plan nuevo.
It was not a new plan.
El plan ya estaba de la fundación.
The plan was already from the foundation.
No soy un teólogo ni doctor de la ley.
I am not a theologian or doctor of the law.
Pero entiendo que el plan de Dios para rescatar al mundo siempre fue que Cristo muriera en la cruz.
But I understand that God's plan to rescue the world was always for Christ to die in the cross.
Y a través de esa muerte, usted y yo,
and through that died on the cross, you and I,
podamos encontrar salvación y seamos ayudados.
We can find hope and salvation through
este
him.
Plan.
This plan,
aún el diablo no sabía.
Even the devil did
el
not
diablo
know
no
the,
conocía
the outcome.
Este plan.
He did not know that plan.
Él no sabía el resultado que iba a provocar la muerte de Cristo en la cruz.
He didn't know the outcome of Jesus dying on the cross.
Nadie conocía ese plan.
Nobody knew that plan.
Solo Dios.
Only God.
1 Corintios 2, 7 y 8.
1 Corinthians 2:7-8.
Pero hablamos sabiduría de Dios en misterio, la sabiduría oculta que Dios predestinó antes de los siglos para nuestra gloria, la cual ninguno de los poderosos de este mundo conoció, porque si la hubiera conocido, nunca habrían crucificado al Señor de la gloria.
But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, the hidden wisdom of God predestined before the ages of our glory, which none of the powerful of this world knew, because if they had known, they have known it, they would never have sacrificed the Lord of glory.
Si hubieran conocido ese plan, dice,
if they knew that plan,
no hubieran crucificado a Jesucristo.
They would not crucify Jesus
Pero
Christ.
Como no conocieron el plan de redención, de salvación,
but since they didn't know the plan of redemption and salvation,
por eso fue crucificado.
That's why he was crucified.
Algunos comentaristas dicen,
some commentaries say,
que aunque Satanás luchó con Cristo,
although Satan fought with Christ,
que no tenía que morir en la cruz,
that he had not needed to die,
él intentaba.
He tried.
No era que él sabía el plan.
He didn't know the plan.
El diablo no conocía ese plan. Quiero que entienda eso.
I want you to understand that Satan didn't know the plan.
Él se interponía para que Cristo no fuera a esa cruz.
He was trying to intervene for Jesus not to go to the cross.
Él no tenía ningún conocimiento de lo que iba a suceder.
He didn't know the outcome of what was going to happen.
No tenía ningún conocimiento del impacto que iba a tener Cristo al morir en esa cruz.
He didn't know the impact that was going to cause once Jesus died on that cross.
Porque no fue revelado.
Because it was not revealed.
La Biblia dice que Satanás llenó el corazón de Judas.
The Bible said that Satan filled the heart of Judas.
Para entregar a Cristo.
To betray Christ.
El diablo pensaba.
The devil thought.
Okay, no puedo hacer que no vaya a la cruz.
Okay, I cannot stop him from here to go to the cross.
Pero lo voy a matar ahora.
But I'm going to kill him in another way.
Voy a destruir.
I'm going to destroy
a Jesucristo.
Jesus Christ.
Voy a hacer que lo lleven una cruz.
I'm gonna make them to take it to the cross.
Y él usó a Judas.
And he used Judas
para entregar a Cristo.
To betray Jesus. To
el diablo
Jesus
pensó
that the devil thought
que al llevarlo a la cruz
that to take him to the cross
todo se iba a acabar.
Everything was gonna finish.
Él iba a reinar.
He was gonna be in the throne.
Él iba a tener la victoria.
He was gonna have the victory.
Pero se equivocó.
But he was wrong.
Amén. Porque Cristo murió y resucitó entre los muertos.
Because Jesus died and resurrected.
El plan para rescatar la humanidad era Cristo.
The plan to rescue humanity was Christ.
Por eso te digo en esta mañana.
That's what I'm telling you this morning.
Que hay esperanza.
That there is hope.
Porque Cristo ha resucitado de la muerte.
Because Jesus had risen from the
dead.
Tu
vida puede cambiar.
Your life can change.
Tu vida puede ser transformada.
Your life can be transformed.
Tu solución puede haber respuesta.
Your solution can have an answer.
Si Cristo no hubiera muerto en la cruz.
If Jesus didn't die on the cross.
Hoy no hubiera salvación para nosotros.
Today there was no salvation for us.
Hoy estuviéramos perdidos.
Today we would be lost.
Atrapados.
Trapped.
En la corriente de este mundo.
In the things of this world.
Estuviéramos esclavos del pecado.
We would be slaves to sin.
Pero porque Cristo murió.
But because Jesus died.
Somos libres.
We are
somos
delivered.
Salvos.
We are healed.
Colosenses 2. Versículo
13-15.
Y a vosotros estando muertos en pecados y en la incircuncisión de vuestra carne os dio vida juntamente con él, perdonándonos todos los pecados. Él anuló el acta de los decretos que había contra nosotros, que nos era contraria, y la quitó de en medio clavándola en la cruz, y después despojó a los principados y a las autoridades, lo exhibió públicamente triunfando sobre ellos en la cruz.
And you began dead in sin and the uncircumcision of your own flesh, he made life together with him, forgiving you all your sins, and annul the records of decrees that was against us, which was contrary to us, and removed it from the way by nailing in on the cross, and he stripped his the principalities and the authorities and made a public display of them, triumphing over them on the cross.
Amén. A través de la muerte de Cristo.
Through the resurrection of Christ,
en esa cruz,
on that cross,
Señor despojó,
that Jesus resurrected,
derrotó al diablo y a sus demonios.
He defeated the devil,
al pecado y a la muerte,
dead and sin.
Ya el pecado no se puede enseñorear en nosotros.
The sin cannot be in us.
Cristo nos dio la victoria.
Christ has given us victory.
A través de su muerte y resurrección.
Through his death and resurrection.
De eso te quiero hablar terceramente, la resurrección de Cristo.
I want to talk to you about the resurrection of Christ.
¿Sabe lo que nos dio la resurrección de Cristo? Fue algo muy tremendo, muy poderoso.
You know what the resurrection gave us?
¿Entiende? Él resucitó de la muerte.
He resurrected from the dead.
Él tuvo una vida nueva, un cuerpo glorificado.
He had a life, a glorified body.
Él tuvo que morir primero.
He had to die.
Para que su cuerpo sea glorificado.
So his body can be glorified.
Él tuvo que morir para tener esa autoridad celestial.
He had to die to have his authority,
poder,
and power.
1 Pedro 3:21-22.
1 Peter 3:21-22.
Es el bautismo que corresponde a esto ahora. Nos salva, no quitando la inmundicia del cuerpo, sino como la aspiración de una buena conciencia hacia Dios mediante la resurrección de Jesucristo, quien habiendo subido al cielo está a la diestra de Dios, y a él están sujetos ángeles, autoridades y poderes.
Amen. The baptism Amen. That corresponds to his now saved up, not by removing filth from the body, but as the inspiration of a good conscience towards God through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who have him ascended to heaven as on the right hand of God, and angels, authorities, and power of the subject are subject to him.
Subió al cielo y dice están sujetos ángeles, autoridades y poderes.
He said he ascended and he has authorities and powers over all things.
Y no solamente los ángeles, sino el mismo diablo y sus demonios están sometidos a Cristo.
Not only the angels, but also Satan and all those are subject to him.
El diablo no tiene poder.
The devil has no power.
Está a los pies de Cristo.
He is on the at the feet of Christ.
Él no tiene ninguna autoridad.
He has no authority.
Cristo lo venció.
Jesus has defeated him.
En la cruz del Calvario.
On that cross.
Él tiene toda la autoridad, hermano.
He has the authority.
Y como hijo de Dios tenemos toda autoridad.
Efesios 1:19-23.
El cual la extraordinaria grandeza de su poder para con nosotros lo que creemos según la acción de su fuerza poderosa. Esta fuerza operó en Cristo, resucitándolo a los muertos y sentándolo a su derecha en los lugares celestiales, sobre todo principado y autoridad, poder y señorío, y sobre todo nombre que se nombra no solo en este siglo, sino también en el venidero, y sometió todas las cosas debajo de sus pies, y lo dio por cabeza sobre todas las cosas. ¿A quién? A la iglesia, la cual es su cuerpo, la plenitud de aquel que todo lo llena en todo.
And what is the extraordinary greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the action of his mighty power? This power worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand of the heavenly places, over all principalities and authorities, power and dominion, and over every name that is named, not only in this age but also on the age to come. And he put all things under his feet and made him head over all things to the church, which is his body, and fullness of him who fills everything in everything.
Cristo tiene todo el poder y autoridad.
Christ has all the power and authority.
Amen.
Amen.
Él pudo hacer la voluntad del Padre.
He was able to do God's will.
Amen. Ahora, ¿cómo nos afecta a nosotros su resurrección?
Now, how this affects us, his resurrection?
Amen. Nos afecta mucho.
It affects us a lot.
¿Cuántos son salvos aquí?
How many are saved right now?
¿Cuánto está obrando ese poder en sus vidas?
How many of those are operating in your life?
Efesios 2, del 1 al 8.
Ephesians 2, 1 through 8.
Léelo, hermano.
He gave life to you when you were dead in trespasses and sin, in which you once walked, following the course of this world according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now works in children of disobedience. Among them we all also once lived, walking in this in the desires of our flesh, doing the will of the flesh and thoughts, and we were not by nature children of wrath, the same as the rest. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love which with which he loved us, even though we were dead in sin, he gave us life together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. He raised us together with him and made us sit in the heavenly places with Christ Jesus, to show in the age to come the abundant riches of his grace and his kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of our yourself. It is the gift of God. Amen.
Amen. Si te das cuenta, antes de Cristo,
before Christ,
estábamos muertos en nuestros pecados. No teníamos vida espiritual.
We had no spiritual life.
Estábamos atrapados en la corriente de este mundo.
We were trapped on this, on the things of this world.
Haciendo las cosas de este mundo.
Doing the things of this world.
Viviendo, haciendo toda clase, cometiendo toda clase de pecado.
Just making all kinds of sin.
Estábamos muertos.
We were dead.
No teníamos voluntad propia.
We didn't have our own will, power of will.
Para dejar de pecar.
To stop sinning.
Pero Cristo.
But Christ.
Nos resucitó.
He resurrected us.
Nos dio la victoria.
He gave us victory.
A través de venir delante de él.
Just through him to come before him.
De entregarle nuestra vida.
And to give our lives to him.
Él nos resucitó.
He resurrected us.
Nos dio vida nueva.
He gave us a new life.
Nos dio poder.
He gave us power.
Nos dio salvación.
He gave us salvation.
Ahora ya no le pertenecemos al diablo.
Now we don't belong to the devil.
Ahora le pertenecemos a Cristo.
We belong to Christ.
Porque fuimos comprados por precio de sangre.
Because we were bought by the price.
Sangre que él derramó en esa cruz.
The blood that was shed on that cross.
Hoy somos salvos.
Today we are saved.
A través de ese sacrificio.
Through that sacrifice.
Tenemos poder a través de ese sacrificio.
We have power through that sacrifice.
Para vivir una vida nueva.
To live a new life.
Mírese ahora.
Look yourself now.
Lo que usted era antes.
Like, who you were before.
Y lo que es ahora.
And who you are now.
Usted tiene vida nueva.
You have a new life.
Porque Cristo resucitó de la muerte.
Because Jesus resurrected from the dead.
Y le dio ese poder.
He gave us that power.
Para que usted pueda tener dominio.
So you can have dominion.
Para que usted pueda experimentar una nueva vida.
So you can experiment that new life.
Para que usted le diga no al pecado.
So you can say no to sin.
Para que podamos vivir una vida libre.
So we can live a clean life.
Antes no la podíamos tener.
Before we couldn't have it.
Pero ahora tenemos poder.
But now we have power.
Para decir no.
To say no.
¿Por qué? Porque tenemos ese poder de la resurrección en nosotros.
Why? Because we have that power of resurrection now.
El mismo poder que a Cristo resucitó de la muerte.
The same power that raised Jesus from the dead.
Lo tenemos usted y yo.
We have it, you and I.
Por eso decimos no al pecado.
That's why we say no to sin.
Por eso decidimos vivir una vida limpia delante de Dios.
That's why we decided to live a clean life for
Christ. Tenemos todo su poder y autoridad.
We have all his power and authority.
El diablo no tiene ninguna autoridad sobre nosotros.
The devil has no authority over us.
Por eso podemos orar por enfermos.
That's why we can pray for sick people.
Y enfermos pueden ser sanados.
And those sick people can be healed.
A través de ese poder de la resurrección.
Through that power of resurrection.
Que hay en nosotros.
That is in us.
Amén.
Amen.
Dios nos ha dado poder y autoridad.
Jesus has given us that power and authority.
Ahora podemos hacer su voluntad.
Now we can do his will.
Por eso tenemos deseo de venir a la iglesia.
That's why we have the desire to come to church.
Por eso tenemos hambre de las cosas de Dios.
That's why we are hungry for the things of God.
Queremos hacer su voluntad.
We want to do his will.
Por eso damos frutos.
That's why we do fruit. We give fruit.
Porque hay ese poder en nosotros.
Because there's that power in us.
Ese poder que a Cristo resucitó de la muerte.
That power that raised Jesus
ese
from the dead.
Opera en nosotros.
That power is in us.
Por eso amamos la voluntad de Dios.
That's why we love the will of God.
Amén. Por eso Amen. Queremos estar cerca de Dios.
That's why we want to be near God.
Por eso odiamos al pecado.
That's why we hate
Decimos
the
no
sin.
Al pecado.
We say no to sin.
Ya no volver a la misma vida de antes.
I'm not going to go back to my old life.
Estamos contentos con la nueva vida que tenemos.
We are happy to the life we have now.
Eso es lo que hace el poder de la resurrección.
That's what that, the power of death does.
Nos lleva a dar fruto de arrepentimiento.
We give us fruit for repentance.
Amén.
Amen.
¿Cuántos siguen haciendo lo mismo que hacían antes?
How many of you are doing the same thing you did before?
Usted ya no se droga, ya no bebe, ya no fuma.
You guys don't drink, do drugs, right?
Ya no anda en las discotecas.
You guys are not at the bars, at the discos.
Ya no anda siendo infiel.
You're not being unfaithful.
Okay.
Okay.
Porque usted tiene nueva vida.
Because you have a new life.
Usted dice esas cosas ya no las quiero.
Those things you say, I don't want them.
Porque hay un poder en mí.
Because there's a power in me.
Que me dice no.
That says no to those things.
Usted ya le tiene asco al pecado.
You guys hate those things.
Usted dice
now.
Yo no quiero volver a repetir la misma historia.
I don't want to go to my old life to do the same things.
Porque tengo poder.
Because now I have that power.
Ahora tengo voluntad.
Now I have will.
A través de la resurrección.
Through the resurrection of Christ.
Puedo hacer la voluntad del Padre.
I can do the will of God.
Puedo hacer la voluntad de Dios.
I can do the will of God.
Puedo dar frutos.
I can give fruit now.
Puedo crecer ahora.
Now I can grow.
Ahora amamos.
Now we love.
Ya no odiamos.
We don't hate.
Ya no somos rencorosos.
We don't feel ahora, any resentment.
Ahora perdonamos.
Now we can forgive.
Porque tenemos vida nueva.
Because we have a new life.
Amen. Juan 12, 24 al 26.
John 12, 24 to 26.
De cierto os digo que si el grano de trigo que cae en la tierra no muere, queda solo, pero si se muere, lleva mucho fruto. El que ama su vida la perderá, el que odia su vida en este mundo para vida eterna la guardará. Si alguno me sirve, sígame, y donde yo esté allí también estará mi servidor. Si alguno me sirve, mi Padre lo honrará.
Truly, truly, I say to you, if the grain of the wheat falls into the ground, does not die, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. He who loves his life will lose it, and he who hates his life in his world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone says, serves me, follows me, and where I am, there will be my servant will also be. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him.
¿Sabe, la clave y el mensaje de la cena del Señor?
You know, the key in the message of the Lord's Supper
es que Jesucristo resucitó de la muerte.
Is that Jesus raised from the dead, rose from the dead.
Y si tú quieres ese poder,
and if you want that power
de resurrección,
of resurrection,
tienes que morir primero.
You're going to have to die first.
Tienes que haber una rendición.
You're going to have to surrender.
Si esta mañana tú no eres salvo,
if this morning you're not
yo
saved,
te digo, estás en el mejor lugar.
I'm telling you, you're at the right place.
No es casualidad que tú hayas venido.
This is not a coincidence that you are here.
Dios ha puesto en tu corazón.
God has put in your heart
de que tú vengas a este lugar.
That you come to this place.
Porque Él tiene un plan para tu vida.
Because He has a plan for you.
Él quiere ayudarte.
He wants to help you.
Quizás en esta mañana estás muerto espiritualmente.
Maybe this morning you're dead spiritually.
Tú no tienes la vida de Cristo.
You don't have God's life.
Pero en esta mañana, a través de venir a este altar,
but maybe this morning coming to this altar,
de rendirle tu vida,
and you surrender your life,
tú vas a morir esa vieja vida,
you're gonna die that old life,
y tú vas a resucitar a una nueva vida,
and you're gonna have a new life.
Cristo va a darte una nueva vida.
God is gonna give you a new life.
Cristo va a restaurar lo que el pecado ha dañado en ti.
God is gonna restore everything that was dead inside.
Él te va a dar la victoria.
He's gonna give you that victory.
Vas a ser más que un vencedor.
You're gonna be a victorious.
Él te va a dar nuevamente voluntad.
He's gonna give you that will.
Para que empieces a vivir una vida nueva.
So you can live a new life.
Pero esta mañana tú tienes que rendirte delante de Él.
But this morning you're gonna have to surrender
morir,
to Him.
Morir a tu carne, a tu yo.
Die to your flesh.
A tu orgullo.
To your pride.
Y rendirte a Dios.
And surrender to God.
Dile, Dios, te necesito.
And say, God, I need you.
Dios, necesito tu ayuda.
God, I need your help.
Necesito que resucites.
I need you to resurrect
lo que está muerto en mi vida.
What's dead in my life.
Aquí hay cristianos.
There's Christians here.
Que hay áreas que necesitan que resuciten.
There are certain areas of your life that you need to resurrect.
Pero esa resurrección va a venir.
But that resurrection is going to come.
A través de que tú te rindas en esta mañana, en esta
through you surrender this morning at the altar.
Dios va a resucitar esas áreas.
God is going to resurrect those areas.
Esas áreas que han muerto.
Those areas that have died.
Señor las va a resucitar.
God is going to resurrect them.
Situaciones que están perdidas.
Situations that are lost.
Dios las va a resucitar.
God is going to resurrect
them. ¿Lo puedes creer?
Do you want to believe that?
Dice el libro de Romanos 8.
It says Romans 8.
Y si el espíritu de aquel que levantó los muertos a Cristo Jesús mora en vosotros, el que levantó los muertos a Cristo Jesús vivificará también vuestros cuerpos mortales con, por su espíritu que mora en vosotros. Esto no estaba en las notas, hermano.
Yeah.
El espíritu que levantó
the spiritual life that got up.
Es el mismo espíritu que está operando en nosotros.
It's the same
es el mismo espíritu que está en esta mañana.
That is operating in you,
es el mismo
in your life,
espíritu que quiere levantarte.
That spirit that
que quiere ayudarte.
It wants to help you.
Amén. Es el mismo espíritu.
The same spirit
está aquí.
It's here.
La presencia de Dios está en este lugar.
God's presence is
hoy Dios
in this
quiere
place.
Ayudarte.
God is going to help you.
Él solamente quiere tu corazón.
He only wants your heart.
Una rendición.
He wants you to surrender.
Que tiene que venir en este altar.
And you have to come to this
Él
altar.
Va a resucitar.
He's going to resurrect.
Lo muerto que está en ti.
That was dead in your life.
¿Lo puedes creer?
Do you want to believe
Vamos
that?
Vamos a inclinar nuestro rostro por un
Let's
momento.
Bow our heads for a moment. Reverence to
nadie
God.
Nadie mirando a nadie. Quiero hacer un llamado.
I want to make a call.
Usted está aquí en esta mañana.
You're here this morning.
Quizás usted no visita por primera vez.
Maybe you should visit us for the first time.
Yo le digo.
I'm telling you.
Como ha escuchado.
Just the way you have listened.
No es casualidad que usted esté aquí.
It's not coincidence that you're here.
Dios te quiere ayudar.
God wants to help you.
Tú ya estás cansado de seguir viviendo esa vida de esa manera.
You're tired of living that old life.
No tienes paz en tu corazón.
You don't have peace in your heart.
No puedes conciliar el sueño.
You cannot sleep every night.
Estás tan atrapado en el pecado.
You're so trapped in your sin.
El pecado te dice, tú no puedes ser libre.
Your sin is telling you, you cannot be free.
Yo te digo algo, tú en esta mañana puedes ser libre.
I'm telling you, this morning, you can
Hoy
be free.
Hoy Dios puede restaurar lo que el pecado ha dañado en ti.
God can restore what sin have destroyed in your
Hoy el
your
Señor
life.
Puede restaurar tu relación.
God can restore your
puede
life.
Darte vida nueva.
He can give you new life.
No importa lo que tú hayas hecho en esta mañana.
It does not matter what you have done in the past.
En que te hayas involucrado.
In whatever you've been involved.
Todo lo malo que tú hayas hecho.
Everything that wrong that you have done.
Yo te digo algo.
I'm telling you something.
Cristo te ama.
God loves you.
Y él quiere perdonarte.
He wants to forgive you.
Él quiere darte una nueva vida.
He wants to give you a new life.
A través de que tú le entregues tu corazón.
Through you giving your heart to him.
Tú necesitas nacer de nuevo en esta mañana.
You need to be born again.
Necesitas tener un corazón nuevo.
You need to have a new heart this morning.
Y ese nacimiento viene.
And that comes
a través de que tú le entregues tu vida a Cristo.
Through you giving your life to Christ.
Ya no intentes por ti mismo.
Don't try to do it on your own.
Querer cambiar.
You want to change.
Es imposible.
It is impossible.
Yo lo intenté por muchos años.
I've tried it many years.
Querer cambiar mi vida.
Want to change my life.
No pude.
And I couldn't do it.
Yo destruí mi vida.
I destroyed my life.
Mi familia.
My family.
Estaba atrapado en el alcohol, en las drogas.
I was trapped in alcohol and drugs.
Una vida infiel viviendo.
Yeah, I was living an unfaithful life.
Yo quería intentar cambiar.
I was trying to change.
No podía.
And I couldn't.
Tuve pensamientos de suicidio muchas veces.
I had a lot of thoughts of suicide.
Yo decía que esa era la salida.
I said that's the exit.
Yo decía todo lo malo que he hecho.
I said everything the wrong that I've done.
No hay perdón.
There's no forgiveness.
Pero un día me dijeron.
But one day they told me
que Cristo podía perdonarme.
That Christ could forgive
que
me.
Que Cristo podía cambiar mi vida.
That Christ could change my life.
¿Sabes? Ese día yo tomé esa decisión.
And that day I took that decision. I made that
de abrirle mi corazón al Señor.
To open my heart to Christ.
De arrepentirme mis pecados.
To surrender and forgive
ese día.
That day
tuve ese encuentro personal con Cristo.
I had that personal encounter with Christ.
Mi vida fue cambiada de ese momento.
My life was changed on
Sentí
that day.
Una paz que nunca la había tenido.
I felt that peace that I've never felt before.
Dios restauró lo que el pecado había dañado.
God restored what
me
sin
dio,
had destroyed.
Me dio una nueva vida.
He gave me a new life.
Me dio voluntad.
He gave me a free,
me dio la victoria.
Hope and victory.
Y me dio destino.
And give me a destiny.
Tú estás en esta mañana.
You're here tonight, this morning.
Dios quiere ayudarte.
God wants to help you.
Tú necesitas de Cristo.
You need Christ.
Entrégale tu vida.
Give yourself to Christ.
Quiero que levantes tu mano.
I want you to raise
como
your hand.
Como señal.
As a symbol of surrender.
Dios, necesito de ti.
God, I need you.
Tú necesitas ser salvo en esta mañana.
You need to be saved this morning. Raise your hand.
Levanta tu mano. Quiero orar por ti.
I want to pray for
Dios
you.
Dios ve esa mano. Alguien más.
God sees that hand.
Alguien más.
Somebody
Dios,
else.
Dios ve esa mano. Alguien más.
God sees that hand.
Dios ve. Okay. Alguien más.
Somebody
tú
else.
Necesitas tener un encuentro personal.
You need to find
tú dices
a
no hay solución ya para
God.
Mi vida. No
There's
hay
no solution
solución
for me.
Para mí, mi hogar, mi familia.
Oh, my family, I see no hope.
No hay esperanza.
There's no hope.
Dios dice, yo voy a restaurarlo.
God says, I'm going to restore that.
A través de que tú me rindas tu corazón.
Through you surrendering your
quiero
life
darte
to me.
Una nueva vida.
I want to give you a new life.
Yo soy la solución que tú andas buscando.
I'm the solution that you're looking for.
No te vas a arrepentir de esto.
You're not going to regret it.
Vas a experimentar.
You're going to experience
esa paz de Dios.
That peace of God.
El gozo del Señor.
That joy of God.
Vas a ver cómo tu vida va a ser transformada y restaurada.
You will see how God's going to transform your life.
Alguien más que se una a estas personas son estas.
Somebody else raise
tú necesitas
your hand.
De Cristo. Prayer.
You need Christ.
Quizás antes servías al Señor y te alejaste y te apartaste.
Maybe before you served God and now you walked away from Him.
Tiempo atrás servías al Señor con todo tu corazón.
Before you served God with all your heart.
Pero algo sucedió en el camino.
But something happened on your walk.
Te apartaste.
That you walked away.
Te alejaste de Dios.
You walked away from God.
Yo te digo en esta mañana.
I'm telling you this morning.
El Señor te está esperando con los brazos abiertos.
God is waiting you with His
te está diciendo que vuelvas.
He's telling you come back.
Y tú necesitas volver nuevamente.
And you need to come back once again.
A reconciliarte con el Señor.
To reconcile yourself.
Levanta tu mano.
Raise your hand.
Necesitas reconciliarte con el
you
Señor.
You need to
levanta
reconcile yourself with God once
y no
again.
Te dé vergüenza. Levanta tu
don't
mano.
Be ashamed.
Ahí donde yo la pueda ver, levanta tu mano.
Raise
rápidamente. Dios ve esa mano.
God sees that hand. God sees that hand.
Necesitas reconciliarte.
You need to reconcile yourself with
amén.
God.
Amén. Gloria a Dios.
Glory to God.
Hermanos que
brothers,
levantaron su mano. Quiero que me
your
miren.
Hand. Can you look at me?
Son honestos. Quiero
if
que
you're
me
honest, look at me.
Quiero que te pongas de pie mientras toda cabeza está inclinada, todo cerrado. Quiero que vengas aquí adelante. Quiero ayudarte. Quiero orar por ti. Hermanos que levantaron su mano, pasen aquí adelante.
Those
rápidamente. Hermanos que levantaron su mano, gloria a Dios.
Glory to God.
Pasa aquí adelante.
Come to the front.
Alguien más ahí atrás levantó
somebody
su
else.
Mano.
They
alguien
raise
más.
Hand. Somebody else.
Necesito hermanos que ayuden a estos hermanos a orar rápidamente. Necesito hermanos que ayuden aquí.
Brothers.
Rápidamente. Alguien más.
Somebody else.
Tú estás aquí.
You are here.
No te resistas.
Don't resist.
Dios te quiere ayudar.
God wants to help you.
No es casualidad.
This is not a coincidence.
Tú quieres aceptar a Cristo, quieres reconciliarte, levántate rápidamente.
God, you want to reconcile with God, get
antes
up.
Que cambie el llamado, rápidamente.
Before changing the order.
Dios está en este lugar.
God
rápidamente.
Is in this place.
Necesitas reconciliarte.
You need to reconcile.
Estás aquí en esta mañana.
You're here this morning.
Quiero que vengas a este altar.
I want you to come to this altar.
Alguien más que me ayude a orar.
Somebody else.
Alguien más.
Somebody else.
Alguien más. Gloria a Dios. Dios
glory
está en
God.
Este lugar.
Glad
necesito una hermana
place.
Que me ayude a orar
I need
rápidamente.
A sister over here.
Alguien más.
Somebody else.
Hay una persona más.
Somebody else.
No te resistas. Dios te está hablando.
Don't resist. God wants to help you.
Dios te dice que vuelvas, que vengas hacia
He's
él.
He's telling you to come back.
Dios va a ayudarte.
God's going to help you.
Dios va a ayudarte.
God is going to help you.
Alguien más.
Somebody else.
Quiere reconciliarte.
He
alguien
wants to
más.
Reconcile
aquí.
Somebody
hay más
else.
Personas en este
There's
lugar.
There's more people over here.
Dios está aquí.
God is here.
Amén. Su espíritu.
His spirit.
Amén. Gloria a Dios.
Glory to God.
Hablando con hermanos de la iglesia.
Talking to the brothers from the church.
Dios quiere una rendición.
God wants a surrender.
Hay áreas aquí.
There are some areas in this place.
Áreas que necesitan resucitar.
Areas that need to be
áreas
resurrected.
De fidelidad, de obediencia.
Obedience, infidelity.
De sometimiento.
Disobedience.
Hay orgullo.
There's pride.
Que tienes que ser quebrantado, tiene que ser muerto en
broken,
este altar.
That needs to be died.
Dios te quiere la victoria, hermano.
God wants to give you victory.
Que hay personas que están batallando con ciertas cosas.
There are people here who are dealing with certain
Dios
things.
Dios te quiere dar la victoria.
God wants to give you that victory.
Tienes que agarrar eso.
You want to grab that.
El mismo espíritu que levantó a Cristo entre los muertos.
The same spirit that raised God from the dead.
Hermano y hermana.
brother and sister.
Es el mismo espíritu.
It is the same spirit
que opera en ti.
That operates on you.
Tienes que creerlo.
You need to believe that.
Tienes que abrazarlo.
You need to embrace that.
Cristo murió, resucitó.
God died and risen.
Y nos dio la victoria.
And he has given us the victory.
Tú eres más que un vencedor.
You are more than conquered.
Simplemente rinde tu vida.
Just surrender your life.
La Biblia dice,
the Bible says,
someteos a Dios,
submit to God,
y el diablo huirá de vosotros.
And the devil will flee.
Ven a rendir tu vida.
You need to submit your
Sométete
life.
A Dios en
submit
este altar.
To God in this place.
Toma la decisión.
Take that decision.
Dios, hoy me rindo a ti.
God, I surrender.
Quiero
this
caminar
morning.
En ese poder de la resurrección.
I want to walk on that power of the resurrection.
Quiero tener victoria en mi vida.
I want to have victory
vamos
in my life.
Vamos a ponernos de pie. Vamos a venir
este altar. Everybody stand up.
Yo te animo a venir a este altar.
I encourage you to come Amen. To the altar. Amen.
Yo te animo a venir a este altar mientras cantamos una alabanza.
Let's come to the altar while we sing a song of praise.
Aleluya. Vamos a alabar al Señor, a ver por Jesucristo. Oh, te exalto, Dios. Aleluya, amén. Tenemos victoria en Cristo Jesús.
We have victory in Jesus Christ.
Jesucristo ha resucitado de la muerte.
Jesus has risen from the dead.
Tenemos poder, autoridad y dominio.
We have authority, power and dominion.
Para decir no al pecado.
To say no to sin.
Para decirle sí a la voluntad de Dios.
To say yes to the will of God.
Para decir sí a servir a Dios con todo
to
nuestro corazón.
To say yes to the will of God with all our hearts.
Amen. Dios ha transformado vidas en esta mañana.
God has transformed lives this morning.
Dios ha traído vida.
God has brought life.
Dios te ha dado poder.
God has given you power.
Dios quiere ayudarte.
God wants to help you.
Hermana, Dios quiere ayudarte.
Sister, God wants to help you.
Dios sabe y conoce.
God knows.
Él ha estado allí en tus momentos de soledad.
He has been there with you when you're lonely.
Tú te has sentido sola.
You have felt lonely.
Quizás desamparada.
Maybe despair.
Pero el Señor dice.
But God says.
Yo he estado allí.
I've been with you.
Quiero ayudarte.
I want to help you.
Quiero darte esa paz.
I want to give you that peace.
Quiero restaurar.
I want to restore.
Ríndeme tu corazón.
Give me your heart.
Ríndeme tu vida.
Surrender your life to me.
Yo voy a hacer cosas grandes.
I'm going to do great things
to you. Si tú me dejas trabajar en ti.
If you allow me to work in you.
Si tú confías en mí.
And if you trust in me.
Pones toda tu confianza.
Put all your trust in me.
Tu enfoque.
Your focus.
En mí.
In him.
Descansas en mí.
You have peace in me.
Yo voy a ayudarte.
I'm going to help you.
¿Lo crees?
Do you believe?
Voy a orar. Padre, en nombre de Cristo Jesús, clamo tu sangre, Dios. Reprendo tu asalto al infierno en el nombre de Jesús. Toca la Padre en el nombre de Jesús. Dios, yo oro contra tu asalto al infierno. Padre, haz una obra poderosa, Dios. Ayúdala, restaura, Padre, lo que el pecado ha dañado en el nombre de Jesús. Aleluya, amén, Dios es bueno.
God is good.
Amén, Dios es bueno.
God is good.
Dios quiere ayudarte.
God wants to help you.
Dios no se ha olvidado.
God has not forgiven you.
Yo no sé lo que tú estés viviendo.
I don't know what you're living through.
Pero Dios sí lo sabe.
God has not forgotten you. God knows.
Ríndete a Dios.
Surrender to God.
Hay confusiones en tu
vida. There's confusion.
Dios quiere traer claridad.
God's going to give you clarity.
Va a traer respuestas.
He's going to bring answers.
Solo búscalo con todo tu corazón.
Just search it with all your heart.
Somete tu vida a Dios.
Submit your life to Christ.
Y Dios va a hacer.
And God's going to do.
Un cambio sobrenatural en tu vida.
And something supernatural, a change in you.
Dios va a restaurar cosas en ti.
God's going to restore things
cosas
in you.
Cosas que en ti están perdidas.
Things that you have
lost. Dios lo va a hacer.
God is going to restore it.
Pero Dios quiere un corazón rendido.
But God wants a surrender heart.
Búscalo a él.
Find it, search it.
Con todo tu corazón.
With all your heart.
Agárrate.
Grab it to that.
Dios quiere ayudarte.
God is going to help you.
¿Crees que es Dios?
You believe it's God?
Que quiero orar por ti, ven aquí.
I want to pray for you.
Vamos a orar. Padre, en el nombre de Cristo Jesús, clamo tu sangre preciosa. Padre, obra poderosamente en su corazón, en su vida. Dios, reprenda tu asalto al infierno. Obra poderosamente. Padre, restaura su corazón y Dios su vida, Padre. En el nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amén. Dele un aplauso a Cristo Jesús. Dios es bueno.
Amén. God is good.
Dios es bueno.
God is good.
Amén. Tenemos poder.
We have power.
Amén. A través de la resurrección de Cristo.
Through the resurrection of Christ.
Somos más que vencedores en Cristo.
We're more than conquerors in Christ.
Amén. El diablo no tiene ya más poder.
The devil has no power anymore.
El pecado no tiene poder sobre nosotros.
Sin has no authority over us.
Ahora tenemos poder en Cristo.
Now we have power in Christ.
Una vida nueva.
A new life.
Amén.
Amen.
¿Cuánto lo creen?
How much
Dios
believe
es bueno.
That is good.
Alguien más rápidamente.
Somebody else.
Usted
quickly.
Aquí tiene algún dolor.
Those who have pain.
¿Quién tiene dolor ahora mismo?
Who has pain right now?
¿Tiene dolor?
Do you have pain?
Okay, vamos a ir rápido. ¿Alguien más?
Somebody else has any pain?
Okay, ¿tiene dolor?
You have pain?
¿A dónde tienes el dolor?
Where are you pain?
En tu rodilla, allí.
My knee.
Okay, usted.
And
en la
you?
Cadera, okay. ¿Alguien más?
Somebody else.
Pongan sus manos ahí donde
put your hands where it hurts.
Iglesia, quiero que levantes su mano.
Church, I want you to raise your hand.
Pon tu mano allí y repite
put
conmigo.
Put your hand where it hurts.
Señor Jesús.
Jesus.
Yo clamo tu sangre preciosa.
I claim your precious blood.
El poder de la resurrección.
The power of resurrection.
Obrando en mi cuerpo.
Wow, to work in my life.
Yo echo fuera ese dolor.
I rebuke that pain.
Por el poder de Cristo Jesús.
With the power of Jesus Christ.
Por la sangre de Cristo.
With the blood of Christ.
Echo fuera ese dolor.
I rebuke that pain.
De mi cuerpo.
For my body.
Ahora mismo.
This very moment.
Soy libre.
I am free.
Por la sangre de Cristo.
Through the
y por
blood
el poder.
And the power.
De la resurrección.
Of resurrection.
Denle un aplauso a Cristo. Padre, tócalo, sánalo, echo fuera ese dolor ahora mismo en el nombre de Jesús. Sánalo, Padre. Tócalos en el nombre de Jesús. Aleluya. Chequea dónde está el dolor.
Where's the pain?
Toca, chequea dónde está el dolor.
Touch it. Has it gone?
You good? Okay. Dolor. Good.
The pain's gone.
¿Tiene todavía?
Do you still have pain?
Sí.
A little bit.
Allí. Poquito. Tócalas, Padre, en el nombre de Cristo Jesús.
Right now,
llamo tu
name.
Sangre. Echo fuera ese olor ahora mismo de tu
sido.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Suelta
la sangre de Cristo.
Declaro
sanidad en esa cintura. En el nombre de Jesús.
Chequéate.
Chequéate.
Check.
¿Está el dolor? ¿No?
More pain.
Ok. Dios ha Jesucristo ha resucitado de la muerte.
God has risen from the dead. Amen.
Guarda este mensaje en tu corazón.
Save this message in your heart.
Ponlo en práctica.
Put it in practice.
Somos más que vencedores en
Cristo.
We're more
than conquerors in Christ.
Pablo decía.
Paul used to say.
Todo lo puedo en Cristo que me fortalece.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens
me.
Todo
lo podemos en Cristo.
We can do all things through
Christ.
Podemos
hacer su voluntad.
We can do His will.
Podemos servir.
We can serve.
Amen.
Amen.
Podemos experimentar.
We can experiment.
Cosas sobrenaturales.
Supernatural things.
Milagros de Dios.
Miracles of God.
A través de la resurrección.
Through the resurrection of Christ.
Amen. Dile un aplauso a Cristo Jesús. Amen. Vamos a
stay up here. Glory to Dios. Praise God. How many appreciate that this morning? Amen. We're going to have you go back to your chairs, beloved. I'm going to take 5 minutes from your time. Listen, we'll let you go. I promise you. Listen, we have a pastor from Spain. Might have been a little longer with the interpretation, but I know you got things to do. One last thing we've got to do, though. You can... probably remain standing is the best thing to do. You can stand up. Ushers, quickly, come to the front. They know what to do. What they're going to do is we're going to have the Lord's Supper next. And so, ushers are going to be in the front. They have in that packets. They're pre-prepared already. And they're going to basically go on the edges. They know what to do. They're not going to pass them all out. It's going to be up to you to individually go to them to pick it and take it. And the reason for that, very quickly, I'm going to read this and we'll let you go. I need an interpreter. Where's Marco? Okay, Marco in Spanish. So you should be interpreted. What we're going to do.
Lo que vamos a hacer
is we're going to have the ushers.
Vamos a tener a los urgés.
And they're going to go down the aisles.
Van a pasar por los pasillos.
You are, if you want to participate,
si quieren participar,
you will go to them,
van a ir a ellos,
get the little packet,
agarran el paquetito,
back to your chair,
y regresan a tu silla,
and wait.
Y esperar.
Then I'm going to read the information, scriptures.
Escrituras.
And so let me just first, before you take a packet,
hay que tomar el paquete. Antes de tomar el paquete,
the Bible says this,
la Biblia dice en esto,
1 Corinthians 11:27,
de Corintios 11:27,
therefore,
sí que,
whoever eats this bread,
que come de este pan,
or drinks this cup,
o toma de esta copa,
of the Lord,
el Señor,
in an unworthy manner,
en una manera no buena,
will be guilty,
o ser culpable,
of the body,
del cuerpo,
and the blood of the Lord,
y la sangre del Señor.
Verse 28, but let a man examine himself,
pero deja que el hombre se examine en sí mismo,
and so let him,
y deja que él,
eat of the bread,
coma del pan,
and drink of the cup,
y bebe de la copa.
The Bible says before you take it,
la Biblia dice antes de que lo tomen,
examine your heart,
examina tu corazón,
are you right with God,
estás bien tú con Dios.
Can you say amen?
Digamos amén.
Otherwise, it becomes a religious procedure.
De otra manera, se hace como un procedimiento religioso.
But we're doing this to remember the Lord.
Estamos haciendo para recordar del Señor.
And His sacrifice.
Y su sacrificio.
And the fact that He loved us.
Y el hecho que Él nos amó.
Died for our sins.
Murió por nuestros pecados.
And rose from the grave.
Resucitó de la muerte.
And when you receive it.
Cuando tú recibes eso.
You're acknowledging that.
Tú reconoces eso.
Through salvation,
por medio de la salvación,
that you're saved,
que tú estás salvado,
and you're doing that,
y estás haciendo tú eso,
saying, Lord, I appreciate,
diciendo, yo agradezco eso, Señor,
and I thank you for that.
Y te doy gracias por eso.
Are you with me?
¿Estás conmigo?
Okay, let's go ahead and now pass it out.
Ahora pasar los paquetitos.
There's music in the background. Jeremiah Wacker has it ready. If they don't want to take it, they don't have to. Just your job is to go down one. Just go down the aisle, it'll come to you. It'll come to you.
How great the chasm that lay between us. How high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. And through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, that has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain.
Turn the volume down, please. As you're passing the package out, you can start preparing it. Is it down a little bit, please, Frank? Just down and off. I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you. That the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread.
And
when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat.
Comer.
This is my body,
este es mi cuerpo,
which is broken for you.
Está quebrantado por ti.
Do this in remembrance
Haz
of me.
Un recordatorio mío.
In the same manner,
de la misma manera,
he also took the cup,
tomó la copa,
after supper,
después de la cena,
saying,
diciendo,
this cup,
esta copa,
is a new covenant,
es una nueva promesa,
in my blood,
en mi sangre.
This do,
esto es,
as often,
tan seguido,
as you drink it,
cuando tú la tomes,
in remembrance of me,
en recordatorio de mí.
For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death
until he comes.
Hasta que
él venga. The angels
roar, Christ
Jesus. Jesus Christ this morning.
Hallelujah. God, you are holy. God, you are worthy. God,
Father, we thank you, Lord God, for all that you've done, God, this morning, Lord Jesus. I thank you, God, for the great sacrifice, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, for this Resurrection Sunday. And I pray, God, as you miraculously help people this morning in salvation and healing in their hearts, Lord God. I thank you for all those that have come, all the visitors, especially, Lord God, a blessing of God upon their lives. God bless this day today. In the name of Jesus Christ, and all of God's people said, amen. Praise God. Consider yourself dismissed. Thank you this morning. Amen.